Hey everyone, Rob Avila here. Today we're going to look at how to install three very powerful tools in your website. Ideally, you would want to install this once you have a new site. So these three tools are Google Search Console, Google Tag Manager, and Google Analytics. First, I'm going to install Google Search Console. Just look it up on Google, click it, and it's going to show this type of screen. It's going to ask you for your URL. So for this demonstration, I'm going to use a URL prefix, and I'm just going to put HTTPS and then yourwebsite.com. So you click continue, and it's going to ask you to verify your ownership. So there's a couple of ways that you can do this. You can upload an HTML file to your website, but really the easiest one would be to use down here other verification methods and use an HTML tag. So you're going to copy the meta tag below and you're going to paste it on your site's homepage. It should go in the head section. So in my case, I'm going to use WordPress. And let's add a new plugin. And this plugin is going to be called insert, just put insert headers. And let's use this one, the insert headers and footers one. You install it. Then you activate it. And now you go down here to settings. You should be able to see it down there in insert headers and footers. So this is the header part, this is the footer. You're gonna paste it, the code that you just copied, on the header section. Make sure you click save. And let's head over back to Google Search Console. So now you just click verify. In my case, I already verified it before, but it's gonna show you a confirmation screen. All right, next, what Google Search Console will do is to show you data about what visitors are searching to find your site. So it will show you some traffic stats and a lot more. So next, let's install Google Tag Manager. And I will install Google Analytics through Tag Manager. So type it in on Google as well. And then you're gonna click on create account. So it's gonna ask you for an account setup. I'm gonna use for this demonstration my mom's website. I'm gonna put Platicarte, the country. I'm gonna put it's in Mexico. The contorney name is just the website name. And it's going to ask you for a target platform. So in my case, it's going to be web. But if you have some apps, then you can choose these ones as well. Click create. You're going to go through the terms of service. Click on accept and say yes. All right. So now we have Tag Manager set up. So now we can grab the code that appears here and we're gonna paste it in the header section in the plugin that we just installed. So let's head back to WordPress and let's actually paste it above that and hit enter one time and let's click on save again. All right, so that should be working. Let's click on OK. And now what we want to do is we want to add a new tag. We will choose the analytics tag. So we first click on tag type. It's going to show us a bunch of tags. We're going to click the Google Analytics Universal Analytics one. Click on that one. It's going to ask us to choose the track type, which is set up in the following page views, so that's good. Then we need to add a new variable. So it's going to ask us for our tracking ID. So now we go over to get that, we go over to analytics, and same thing, look it up on Google, click it, and then it's going to ask you to create a new account. So let's create the account. So I'm gonna put the same Don't worry about all this. Click on next. The same thing, what do you want to measure? In this case is your website. Click on next. It's gonna ask you for the website name. Click. And then the URL as well. The industry, in this case is education. The time zone, in my case Chicago. Let's click on create. It's gonna ask you to accept some other terms. Let's click on I accept. And we should have Google Analytics set up. It's gonna give you the tracking ID. So you need to copy this ID, and let's head over to Google Tag Manager and let's paste it there. Perfect. So it's gonna go into automatic. Now let's click on save. Save, that's fine. And now we're gonna have to add a trigger. So let's click there. By default, it's gonna be on all pages, which is totally fine. And also we can change the name here at the top, and let's put analytics. Let's click on save. And now we're gonna publish our container. We're gonna publish this setting. So on the top right, you'll see submit. And it's gonna ask you for a version name. In this case, it's just for your own information. So we're gonna click a V1. And a description, which is totally optional. You can put, in my case, let's say added analytics, so you have a good track of everything you're doing. And let's publish it. All right, so now we have published our settings and everything should be working properly. So that's it. I hope this helps. Thanks again for watching, and please let me know if you encounter any troubles. Have a great one.